All right, it is the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. How you doing today? Hopefully you're off to a fantastic start. Remember to follow me on Twitter at Radio Guy. Instagram is Radio Guy 22. The website is obnradio.com. Of course, we are on YouTube. You can go to Open Mic Broadcast Network. That is OBN, capital M-I-C. That is all one word, and of course, Broadcast Network. If you're on the go, you can check us out by simply dialing 605-477-5066. And don't forget our message line. You can leave your thoughts, comments, concerns, questions, and even suggestions by simply dialing 713-570-6736. And without any further ado, we'll jump right into today's episode of the Mike Prince Show on the Open Mic Broadcast Network. Well, you heard us talk about the moves that were made in regards of the SWAC making sure that they secure a football championship and the basketball championships in Birmingham, Alabama. Many of you are in disagreement with that move, but I discussed on how I see this being a solid move and a move of some solidarity as far as the conference is concerned. Still some things to be worked out, still some plans to be developed, if you would, for the further continuancy of the conference as a whole moving in the right direction. And another thing that really and truly, from my vantage point, that I think that the conference needs to look at as a whole is adding value to the conference by getting tangible property. By that I'm saying no renting, have a building that the conference owns, which adds what? It adds value to the conference. When you can have your own building, that way in the long run, it cuts down your overhead. Yes, you could have some deals worked out with cities. You can have deals worked out with certain organizations. But when you own your own property, when you are the controller of your own destiny, you then begin to paint pictures and lay out formats that can be conducive for you as an organization. So with that being said, we are still in the mix of looking for a commissioner for the Southwestern Athletic Conference. For the most part, there's been one name that has been echoed, but another name has been in place. So it boils down to these two individuals with an opportunity to separate themselves, if you would, from one another. And how would that happen? What does one bring over the other, or vice versa? Still a lot to be determined. The key factor right now is someone has to take the bull by the horns. Someone has to step up and say, here I am, I'm your guy. Now, whether that's on the president's or the chancellor's, yet to be seen. But a move must be made. We are steady losing time. We're steady losing ground. We're steady losing money as a conference when we do not put people in place that we can all move in the right direction. And speaking of moving in the right direction, the Prairie View A&M University 44th Annual National Alumni Association will be on July 19th through the 21st in the Big Easy. Of course, that is New Orleans, Louisiana. Prairie View will be in full effect to go ahead and discuss the world of PV Nation as we have grown to know and love. And with that being said, you can be sure to be informed and enlightened with the Athletic Summit that is scheduled for July 21st, which will be that Saturday. We are still working on the actual time, and we'll get that out to you as soon as possible. You can follow me on Twitter at Radio Guy, and we could text that information out to you once we get it out. I said text or tweet, whatever you want to call it, but follow us at Radio Guy, and we'll get that out to you as soon as we get updated. And speaking of updates, it has been whispered and rumored about some of the moves that are being made for Grambling Nation. Grambling Nation is doing some major upgrades, getting things acclimated with their football program, and it has been whispers and murmurings that in 3 years, Grambling would seek to leave the Southwestern Athletic Conference, allegedly. Now, of course, Grambling has had huge success on the football field. They've had so much success that by far they are still the team to beat, even though there have been major, major exodus from key players in their program, aka Devontae Kincaid. But the problem is not whether or not they can replace a Kincaid. Are you jumping ahead of the gun? Yes, you have had major, major success under Roderick Favre. Outstanding job. He has resurrected that Eddie Robinson swag, if you would. But let's be honest, and I'm honest with PV Nation every day, and I try to be honest and transparent with SWAC Nation every day. You have had one heck of a run, Grambling, and you are still considered the top dog in football. In football. Does that give you enough weight and consistency throughout your other programs to consider jumping from the Southwestern Athletic Conference to an FBS conference? I only think you would be hurting yourself. Now, if it were me, maybe you go independent as a football program, keep the rest of your athletics in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. I don't know what the overall solution would be. You can get more money days or money games throughout becoming independent. But if you are to put your entire athletic program into an FBS conference, I really think that would be extremely premature. Extremely premature. I think you have more to gain staying in the conference. Also, by staying in the conference, you can take on those FBS opponents and have great paydays, great success, continue your recruiting powers as you have over the past few years. You did outstanding against Arizona a couple of years back, making some things happen, doing some big splashes in the water. But to do that on a consistent basis, I don't know. Maybe it's something in the water down in G Nation. Not real sure. I know there was talks about Prairie View perhaps trying to switch conferences some couple of years back. But once again, I don't think it's advantageous. I think that you maximize everything that you have. Yes, in 3 years or so, things could change. And I'm going to be doing another follow-up report. Does facilities actually improve your program? That was a study that I've been researching that would beg to differ that it's all about facilities. But once again, if people feel good about situations and circumstances, they have a tendency to want to do better. The old adage, if you look good, you feel good. And if you feel good, you do good. And maybe that has some merits or not, but not real sure if the rubber is going to meet the road on that particular test. But we'll talk about that at another time. Is G Nation ready for the FBS? Football, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would give you even a 7. But for the rest of your athletic programs, I would have to honestly give you anywhere between a 3 and a 4. And that would be consistent misery. You still have other programs. Let's be honest. You had a great first year under Dante Jackson for basketball because he came in and got some things done, replacing Walker after Walker had a pretty significant run. But he and athletic director Paul Bryan, I think that's a brilliant name, even though you have two versions of the Paul Bryan, of course, Alabama, and of course now Grambling. But Paul Bryan and Coach Walker agreed to go separate directions, and Jackson comes in and does a heck of a job. But you have to keep the consistency going on. let's be honest, our programs, not just HBCU, but collegiate programs, are measured tremendously by football and men's basketball. Those are your revenue generating sports. And if you're not consistent in those areas, you begin to be walking and treading on shaky ground, i.e. the challenge for PV Nation. PV Nation has great facilities. We're building a new way of doing things, if you would. We're now under the Eric Dooley era when it comes to football. We're under the Byron Smith era when it comes to men's basketball. If you want to add women's basketball, we're now under the era of Miss Sandy Pugh. But we have to be able to be true to ourselves. And if you listen to this show with any consistency, some of the challenges that I get is because I'm honest. And charity begins at home. I'll look at PV Nation with a whole. If you remove the 2009 football championship, the 2009 football championship, which put PV Nation back on the map, if you remove that year, what have we, PV Nation, done of consistency when it comes to football, when it comes to men's basketball? Because we're measured by championships. That's what we're measured by. Yes, we're graduating because that's part of the goal. They're student athletes, but we are measured by championships. We have one championship in those categories that I just called off, football and men's basketball. Are we making leaps and bounds and strides toward those goals? Absolutely. But until proven otherwise, we have to keep grinding out the mission of championships. Back to G Nation. You've won some championships in football. 5-year run, if we want to be technical about it. Is that enough to consider jumping to another conference? Not our decision to make, not my decision to make. Ultimately, that will be down to G Nation. But let us make sure that we count up the entire cost of what it would take to jump onto that next level. As I mentioned earlier, there were talks around PV Nation. Quite honestly, I do not desire to see PV Nation or Grambling lead the Southwestern Athletic Conference, because I believe we have so much more to tap into. We have so much more to gain, and we're talking about holding on to the nostalgia of what we call the Southwestern Athletic Conference. And by being able to refocus and redesign our programs, and let's go out there and let's beat the Goliaths. Let's go and show them that there's still some ways of getting it done the right way, even when the money is not necessarily balanced out like it should. But we can still get some things done in a decent and orderly manner. Just some little tidbits to share with you along the way. Don't forget, our message line is 713-570-6736. You can dial in 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Share your thoughts, comments, questions, or concerns about it. We got some big interviews coming up planned for you on this week. Yes, this week. And I know we're running out of the week, but they're coming, and they're coming real soon. Stay tuned right here at the Mike Broadcast Network and the Mike Show as we stay on the grind, on the forefront of giving you what you need, when you need it, and how you need it. TV Nation, let's stay on the grind. G Nation, we'll reevaluate. And let's be it's football season, baby. TV Nation, I am the radio guy, the doctor, I trust. And And until the next time, you guys be blessed. We'll see you on the other side. All right.